Alan Buckley. I'm an attorney, a CPA from Atlanta. I'm married. I have two children. Went to law school at UGA. And the only reason I'm doing this is because I believe our country has financial cancer, and it's slowly going to implode. I'm going to show you some charts just so it's really easy to follow. 2007, 9 years ago, the GAO, that's the Government Accountability Office, said, and you'll notice I have this memorized, GAO's current long-term simulations continue to show ever larger deficits, resulting in a federal debt burden that ultimately spirals out of control. That was said in 2007. The debt then was just under $9 trillion. Now it is almost $20 trillion in just 9 years. And the next decade will lead to only another $8 to $12 trillion worth of debt, depending on what happens with recessions and whatnot. You might have heard Hillary last night saying she's not going to add anything to the deficit or the debt. That just means she's not going to make it worse. She's not going to do anything about it. We've got to stop it. Next chart, I want to show you what debt's spiraling out of control looks like in graphic form. These charts, these all come from the federal government. I didn't make these up. This next chart, the red chart, shows debt as a percentage of GDP. See where it was in World War II? That's the chart here. Right now we're about where we were at the end of World War II. We're at about 105, 106% of GDP for total debt. And when you see up in here, we're headed towards the upper point, which before we get there, the financial markets will collapse. The stock market is going to collapse. A guy named Gene Sterling, former Assistant Deputy Secretary of the Treasury, said in a book that he wrote 2 years ago about the debt situation, he said, nations that face exploding debt levels, the kind outlined above relating to the United States, often refuse to pay their debts and declare bankruptcy. Because so many nations depend on the U.S. dollar to stabilize world markets, a U.S. default could prompt not just a U.S. crisis, but a global depression. Now, what's happened historically, the blue line is debt as a percentage of the GDP, the red line is money supply. In 2008, 2009, the Fed started printing a lot of money, and it took that money and it bought T-bills. It bought the higher paying T-bills to push down the interest expense of the federal government. Last year, the Fed made $117 billion in profit, which it sent back, after it took some money, sent them to the banks, sent back to the Treasury to cut down the interest expense. There's only so long games like this can go on. If debt spiral out of control, it's going to be ugly. What does it exactly look like? Does it mean a huge amount of inflation? I really don't know. Who's got the timer?
One more minute,
okay. Here's where the money gets spent. You can see 51% goes to Medicare, Medicaid, Social Security. 19% goes to other entitlements, so 70% goes to entitlements. 80 years ago, it was 0%. Here's the national defense, here's the rest of the government in interest. Here's where it's headed. By 2033, the tax revenue just covers Medicare, Social Security, and Medicaid, and interest on the debt. In reality, it collapses somewhere between 2022 and 2030, because the markets say this can't go on. What does that look like? I don't know, and I don't want to know. If you send Johnny Isaacson back to Washington, we'll find out. If you send Jim Barksdale to Washington, we'll find out. The only way anything gets done in the U.S. Senate race is if I win. That sounds self-serving, but it's true. Georgia can send a message to the rest of the country. We get it. We're willing to sacrifice to save our country. Let's start now. Thank you.